Cassava is an energy-rich crop. So when you eat cassava, you meet more than 80% of your daily energy needs just by a simple meal of 500 gram worth of cassava food. So cassava has no problems with supplying you more than enough energy. But when you eat cassava, and you probably don't eat enough of other things that will supplement for the other nutrients that your body requires, for example, vitamins, like vitamin A, you get less than 10% or 10% of what your body needs, less than 20% of what your body needs in terms of iron and all the other nutrients. So how can we have a more wholesome meal of cassava?
Since the introduction of cassava 150 years ago, a lot of farmers within in Uganda have evolved with cassava, partly because of the crop's importance, how it is resilient to the environment, and how well it answers the demands of food insecurity among household farming communities. But now we know nutritionally, the crop is on a disadvantage. A lot of farmers consume it basically for food, but then they are exposed to the challenge of hidden hunger because they get limited access to getting other nutritional values that are needed for the body. Now we are talking about farmers that actually consume cassava on a daily basis at proportionately higher quantities that would have been balanced with other sources of food that carry other nutrients. So within that concept, then we understand having to improve this cassava to carry that additional benefit of extra nutritional quality should offer that advantage to such farmers.
With bitter carotene, we are excited also because right now we know that in Uganda, a number of people, especially children under the age of 5, have blindness due to vitamin A deficiency. So if the bitter carotene cassava comes out very soon, it will help to reduce the number of young children that get blind, especially before under the age of 5.
Yeah, there are some the yellow roots. The importance of the yellow roots here is because of the bitter carotene, which is a source of vitamin A. Yeah, what you are seeing here, on this side is the white fleshed cassava, which is the most common. But on this side we have the yellow root cassava. But as you can see, there are different colors of yellow. This one is light, this one is a bit deep, and then this one is deeper. And the deeper the yellow is, the better carotene you get from it. But we are trying to promote the use of this.
25% of children under 5 in Nigeria are deficient in iron. So how can we reach those people? So we think cassava, because those same people are the people who depend on cassava for their daily meals. If they eat cassava that is biofortified with iron, how would that improve their health and their cognitive development?
The biofortified cassava has a lot of promise to address vitamin A deficiency and reduce hidden hunger. And it's definitely also a trait, the provitamin A content of cassava roots is a trait that genomic selection is likely to be successful on.
This is going to give a new direction to cassava production because it will package cassava as more complete food crop that will probably interest many other communities to take up the crop. We know how adaptive it is to answering the challenges that come with climate change, but a lot of people disregard it because they think nutritionally it is a poor crop. But so when we can package a nutritious crop, I'm sure it will arouse interest in many more farmers that are going to take up the crop. But then, of course, it improves their food security, income security as well, and nutritional status.